Mr. Transformers 96 here with another video where we're going to be talking about a newly shown Hot Toys figure, and this time it is Star Wars from The Last Jedi, Kylo Ren. So this is quite exciting. I will say that I was pretty disappointed with Hot Toys for Force Friday, considering usually they show about four figures. They show like one, I guess the main, like, Sith, you can call them, and then they'll show, like, three troopers. That's what they've done for Rogue One, as well as for The Force Awakens. However, with The Last Jedi, all they did was show an Executioner Trooper and some Cos Babies, which, you know, are pretty disappointing. So, I was disappointed by that. However, as you can see, just, you know, the next week, less than a week later, they show us the main Sith, as you would for the new movie, which is Kylo Ren, of course. So, I'm very happy about this. I do hope that it doesn't stop here. I would hope that they continue to show more Star Wars figures over the next couple of weeks, because I am really excited for The Last Jedi now. I'm more excited for that movie than I've ever been before, so I'm very excited. But overall, going over Kylo Ren, just so you know where I stand, I do have the original one, and I absolutely love it. It was my favorite Hot Toys of the year last year, And you know, I absolutely adore that figure. I love the character of Kylo Ren, and I was planning on getting this new one. Now, going over this new one, this is a mixed bag for me. There's some things that I see about it that I absolutely love, and then there's some things that disappoint me to my very core. So going over the actual figure here, starting off with the head sculpt, this is going to be the weakest area. I'm not a fan of this head sculpt. I don't think that it completely captures Adam Driver, and it doesn't capture him in the role of Kylo Ren. And really, what's a shame is, you know, usually with the head sculpts like this, if they're off, they're usually off from just some angles, and then there might be like an angle where it looks pretty solid. But with this one, he just looks equally off from every angle. Like, there's not a single angle where I'm like, ooh, I kind of see it there, you know? I think that it just looks off on every angle. Giving you a little comparison here. Now, this is obviously Kylo Ren's appearance in the first film, you know, The Force Awakens. We don't actually have a solid image of him from The Last Jedi without his helmet on. The only one that we can see him in like that is in the trailer, but it's a close-up shot, as well as he's holding his lightsaber in front of his face. But overall, going over this head sculpt, it doesn't look accurate to me. You know, I'm not 100% sure on what exactly I would categorize as wrong with the face itself, but just looking at the two of these together, they do not look, you know, accurate. There's slight similarities. I think that the jawline is an issue. I think that's something that's definitely off. The eyes look a bit off, maybe, and then the nose looks pretty. It's hard to say. Maybe they've elongated the nose too long on the Hot Toys one, but they didn't make it quite as thick enough. That might be an issue. So, you know, there's little things that I think are off about it. Also, the hair looks really off. However, possibly he gets a slightly new hairstyle for this new movie. However, I will say in that shot of the Last Jedi trailer, his hair does look more like the Force Awakens hair. This one on the Hot Toys one just looks a little too wet, and just kind of like it looks like the first Kylo Ren, but with his hair wet. That's what it looks like. So I'm not a big fan of that. Now, if it's accurate to the movie, then okay, that's great. But comparatively speaking, I liked his hair from the first one better, and I think it looks a lot more interesting. So I'm not sure if that's just Hot Toys screwing up, or that is just his new hairstyle in the new movie. But overall, I definitely see flaws in this head sculpt. I will say that the scar looks excellent. It looks very natural, and it's pretty subtle, but it's very visible. So I do very much like the scar, but just the overall face design, the shape of the head, I do think that it is off, which is very disappointing, because that is that was like the biggest reason that I wanted the new Kylo Ren figure. It was for the Adam Driver head sculpt, because that was something that the first one didn't come with, which was absolutely ridiculous that it didn't come with. So I was really looking forward to this one, especially since the one that they made for the 1 in 4 scale Kylo Ren looked pretty solid. You know, and usually the 1 in 4 scale figures have a harder time getting the head sculpts right, because the bigger the figure gets, the harder it is to do the detail, because you have to do more of it. So I figured that the 6 scale one would be really perfect, and unfortunately, it was pretty disappointing. Going over the actual just rest of the figure, first of all, well, you can put the helmet on him. I will say that the helmet looks weird on him. I don't know why, but it looks like it's too big or something, because it does look rather strange. But on the rest of his costume, I do like it quite a bit. As you can see, it does look quite nice. The design of the costume very much, you know, is like the first original version. I will say that, especially the arms look exactly the same. Now, I'm a big fan of that because I absolutely love the first Kylo Ren's arms. I think that they look great and they articulate so well, and that the material is just excellent. I really do love it. The cape, I think that the cape looks spectacular. I absolutely love it. It's like a leather-like look, but it looks like it hangs like almost like a silk. It looks like it's got the texture of leather, but it hangs like a silk. Like, look at that. It hangs so well. You know, I hope that that's actually how it hangs in person, because it looks quite spectacular. So I'm a big fan of that. Going over what you actually get with this figure, you're going to get, obviously, the head sculpt to the helmet. You'll get a secondary hand for the light-up lightsaber, which I will not use. The light-up lightsaber attachment pieces, it's broken on two of my figures. First of all, it was Kylo Ren. The first one, it did break. It broke the elbow joint. I did get a replacement from Sideshow, but then it also happened to my Finn figure, and I haven't been able to get a replacement on that one, unfortunately. So that is just a huge disappointment. I love the idea of a light-up lightsaber, but it's totally not worth the risk because it breaks so easily. So really not happy with that. He comes with an assortment of hands, all of which are not too special. I mean, you get a pair of fists, pair of relaxed palms, pair of hands for holding the lightsaber, and then one force hand. And it's the same exact force hand as the last movie. I wish that he came with the force hand for both sides, and then I wish that there was like a more subtle force hand, and then a more extreme one like he has there. That would have been really nice. As far as his base is concerned, I absolutely love the artwork on his base. That looks like a great, great artwork, and I hope that that's like the theme of the Last Jedi bases, because that looks excellent. Overall, it looks like an excellent figure, except for the head sculpt. That's the big issue, and unfortunately, the head sculpt is arguably the most important part of the figures, so I'm quite disappointed, and now, you know, even though I was planning on getting this one, now I'm not sure. I could definitely see myself skipping it and just purchasing the Kylo Ren from Star Wars 9, because I'm sure, you know, they'll obviously redo the head sculpt for 9, and it'll probably be much improved. Who knows, maybe they will improve this before it gets released. However, you know, I certainly don't like to bet on that, because a lot of the times it doesn't improve much. So overall, I'm a little disappointed with this figure, but I am happy in some areas. The cape looks excellent. Looks like he has great articulation, which the first one did as well. So, you know, I would imagine that would carry over. But really disappointed that the Adam Driver head sculpt is disappointing. Now, let's talk about some of the characters in the background of these photos, the Praetorian Guards. All three of them have been shown in the background of the Kylo Ren photos, which is amazing and just super exciting. The Praetorian Guards look excellent. As you can see, the armor is super shiny. And they do have their weapons, of course. You know, now that I'm thinking about it, maybe just make a separate video talking about these. Yeah, I think I'm going to do that. So let me stop it here, actually. You know, sorry, last minute change. As far as how much the price is going to be on this guy, it's unknown at the moment. It's not on pre-order. I would imagine that this will be $235. That would be my guess. The original one was $225, and that was 2 years ago, as well as it didn't include the Kylo Ren head sculpt. So I would imagine that the price is $235. I think that's a pretty solid guess. And again, I'm really unsure if I'm going to buy this. I could see myself buying it. I could see myself skipping it. No matter what, though, I will eventually buy another Kylo Ren with an Adam Driver head sculpt, because that is very important to the character. And although I absolutely adore the first Kylo Ren, you know, it would be nice to get another one, considering it's such a great figure to begin with. So there you go. That's my thoughts on this Hot Toys Kylo Ren figure. I guess stay tuned for my video talking about the Praetorian Guards that are kind of revealed in the photos of Kylo Ren. And thanks so much for watching.